Hi everybody, today we concern with Cryptococcus neoformans, introduction, morphology, pathogenesis, lab diagnosis and treatment. So let's start with introduction. Cryptococcosis is a fungal infection caused by Cryptococcus neoformans, a capsulated yeast. It is a soil saprophyte and is particularly abundant in the fecal of pigeon. It does not appear to infect bird, probably because of their high body temperature. Cryptococcal infection occurs throughout the world. Now about morphology.
Spherical, budding cell, size of 5 to 15 micrometer in diameter, having a prominent polysaccharide cap as shown in this video. It is a true yeast and is gram positive. Here you can see. Capsule may be demonstrated by India ink or Neurosin preparation. That here you can see. Antigenicity. On the basis of cryptococcal polysaccharide antigen, Cryptococcus neoformans has 4 serotypes. A, B, C and D. A and D are most common infection types. Source of infection. Infection is usually acquired by inhalation of dust containing yeast cells. Pathogenesis. Cryptococcus neoformans is pathogenic in humans and animals. The disease is usually seen in immunocompromised hosts. Most infections are asymptomatic. Pulmonary cryptococcosis may lead to mild pneumonitis. Cryptococcal meningitis occurs by hematogenous spread. It is often seen in AIDS patients. Skin, lymph nodes, bones, and other organs may be involved when dissemination of infection occurs. Cutaneous cryptococcosis varies from small ulcer to large granulomas. Visceral forms of cryptococcal infection stimulate tuberculosis and cancer clinically. Now about lab diagnosis. Collection of a specimen. A specimen depends on the site of infection. In case of meningitis, we need CSF. Whereas in case of pulmonary cryptococcosis, we need a sputum. Similarly, other specimen may be pus, brain tissues. Direct microscopy. A specimen mixed with a drop of India ink or Neurosin shows around budding yeast cells. In India ink, capsule appears as a clear halo around the yeast cell. Here you can see. Gram staining shows gram positive yeast cells. This one. The histopathological examination of tissue can be done by staining with hematoxylin and eosin. Pass and Muscicaramine stains. Culture sediment from a centrifuged CSF is inoculated on a
subarachnoid dextrose agar in brief SDA and incubated at 37 degrees Celsius. Other specimens may also be inoculated on SDA. Cryptococcus neoformans grows to form a smooth, mucoid, cream-colored colonies. Here you can see. Lactophenol cotton blue mount shows budding yeast cell, which is present here. Niger seed or bird seed agar is a differential medium for presumptive identification of Cryptococcus neoformans. It produces brown colonies on this medium.
Within 1 week, when incubated at 30 degrees Celsius, Cryptococcus neoformans produce phenol oxidase, which oxidizes the caffeic acid in the Niger seed into melanin. In this way, latex agglutination test, cryptococcal capsular polysaccharide antigen can be detected in CSF, serum or urine by latex agglutination test. Animal inoculation test, intracerebral or intraperitoneal inoculation into mice leads to a fatal infection in case of Cryptococcus neoformans. Capsulated budding yeast cells can be demonstrated in the brain of infected mice. Other test, urea hydrolysis test, positive. Differentiation of Cryptococcus neoformans from other non-pathogenic cryptococci. For example, Cryptococcus albidus, Cryptococcus laurenti, Cryptococcus gatti. Cryptococcus neoformans has ability to grow at 37 degrees Celsius. Urea hydrolysis positive, produce brown colonies on Niger seed agar, produce disease in mice. In the case of animal inoculation test positive. Now about treatment. Treatment for Cryptococcus neoformans infection. People who have Cryptococcus neoformans infection need to take prescription antifungal medication for at least 6 months, often longer. The type of treatment usually depends on the severity of infection and the part of body that are affected. People who are asymptomatic infection, for example, diagnosed via targeted screening, or mild to moderate pulmonary infections, the treatment is usually fluconazole. For people who have severe lung infections or infections in the central nervous system, that is brain and spinal cord, the recommended initial treatment is amphotericin B in combination with fluocytosine. After that, patient usually need to take fluconazole for an extended time to clear the infection. But point to be noted, the type, dose and duration of antifungal treatment may differ for certain groups of people, such as pregnant women, children and people in resource-limited settings. Some people may also need surgery to remove fungal growth, that is cryptococcomas. I hope this information will be helpful. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.